Sup people in YouTube, this is Ibnir, and I'll be commentating over this match between Millennium's Feast, playing as the Protoss at 5 o'clock position, and Slayer's MMA, playing as Terran on the 7 o'clock position. So this is not a mirror match, and this map is Shakura's Plateau. Haven't guessed the game of this match yet, so this is gonna be interesting. Haven't seen the tactics yet, and also this is not crossplay, so MMA, Millennium's Feast is not playing in this corner, so it's not cross. He's not playing cross. He's a cool guy. They're almost next to each other. Almost, but this is not a spawn play, so you can't really spawn there. But yeah, actually, you already noticed that I used the o'clock thingy. And actually, a viewer notified me of a couple of mistakes I made. A couple of pretty basic mistakes, but he said I should really watch it, so I take advice from my viewers pretty like heavily. Like, if they dislike something I do, I try to make myself better at commentaries to help you get even better commentaries about StarCraft 2 and of course other games, but this is StarCraft 2, so it's just those comments were just about StarCraft 2. And one of those comments was that I should use the o'clock, the hour thingy. That when you say that Millennium Feast is in the 5 o'clock position, that's here, and this one is 7 o'clock. This one in the middle, 6 o'clock, so at least I think that's it. But yeah, that's going to make it a lot easier. Like I would usually say, like MMA playing in the bottom left thingy. And that's like, yeah, that was really badly done, so. But I'll watch that. Millennium's Feast just peeking through, getting his probe in there, trying to see if something weird is happening. Not too weird. MMA just walling off. His ordinary Terran wall offs, and Terrans can indeed wall off. Like, Protoss can wall off with a Forge Fast Expand, but yeah, actually, they can do it here pretty nicely with this ramp here. If they can block up this ramp, that's gonna be nice. It's a nice Forge Fast Expand, but he doesn't go for it. He goes for the gateway first, and then just Cybernetic Core going to pump out that Stalker. Also pumping out a Zealot just to defend it and everything. Going to kill off that SCV there. So actually changing his waypoint a little bit. Where is it going? There we go. Oh, nope. Change it. Not going to chase this SCV. Okay. You can do that. The probe was taken out. Yeah, it was taken out or he escaped. I think it was actually taken out. MMA is gonna see that a Nexus is going up at the first expansion. So he's gonna get that intel. I know an MMA knows by that there's no rush, no weird strategy, just an expand. Not the earliest expand with a Forge Fast Expand, but just an expand. So MMA can take a deep breath and just he's clear of any danger for now. Because of course Archons and Colossus and especially AoE units, they just slaughter your Marine army. And MMA, he played, at least in the previous matches, he played heavy Marine. He always used a lot of Marines. Almost no use of Marauders in his play whatsoever. The only differences he made was in the first match versus Senio. Then he used Thor, which actually didn't help him out a lot there, but still pretty funny. And in the other match between MMA and, let me actually check this. Where is it? Puma. Yeah, sorry, my memory's pretty bad, but yeah, between MMA and Puma, they actually went almost all Marine, just used a couple of siege tanks there. MMA build a bunker, going to land his orbital command over here to start mining off his second expansion, since he's a little bit behind on mining. Feast going for the robotics bay, so we might see some. Yeah, I don't actually know. It could go immortal play, although. Well, it's nice versus siege tanks. And you can go Colossus play, since it's nice versus very heavy Marine play. So it's just a nice strategy there. Meanwhile, MMA just got his expansion up and running a little bit. Brought his mule in. Couple of SCVs transferred over. Building a factory, probably just for building add-ons. He did this before. Or maybe go for siege tank. But Feast will be able to counter this with his Immortals, since Immortals got their hardened shields and will only do 10 damage out of I think it was like 26 or something. Yeah, just build it just for the add-on, since Helim play versus Protoss. Like, I don't say it couldn't work, but I don't think you want to risk it in this kind of match. This is, even though this is for third place, you still don't want to risk it. Like, there's money on the line. Is that from a movie? MMA playing heavy turtle style here. Got three bunkers up. This is... I don't know if this is going to be too great for him, since he will be locked down at his first expansion. Oh, nope. There the stalkers go. Okay, so he isn't yet locked down, but... I don't know. Yeah, there's indeed fly a starport over there. Start pumping out medevacs, since you are definitely going to need them. Or maybe even Vikings. Like, Vikings are very nice versus the Colossus. No, just pump out medevacs. Since he is not sure... Yeah, Feast is also not building any, like, Colossus whatsoever, so... He's chilling with the Twilight Council. Might go into Archon play, since that is also very strong against most Terrans. Since they, tend to clump up all their units, and Archons do pretty heavy AoE damage. Got some heavy shields. Their shields upgrade, that's gonna be a pain in the... In like a limb. Not gonna say that word, but MMA actually building a third expansion over here, over in the, what is it called? 9 o'clock position. So interesting choice there. Probably Feast not even thinking he would take that, possibly, since normally Terran are just leeching off of two bases and only getting three when it's gonna get heavy, but does move out. Got one Marauder there. Yep, one Marauder, just all Marines and two Medivacs. Now I don't think, what does Feast have? He's got... Yeah, he got a couple of Stalkers, so he might be able to hold this off. Got a couple of Sentries, because split pretty nicely. MMA launching up his units. Might think there's actually a base here or something, but there isn't. Isn't at all, so maybe he thought... Maybe he's just going around here. Going around and then drop over here and try to destroy as much of these probes as possible. But these stalkers are here. He's warping in even more stalkers. So this army, this is one frightening army. Even though Marines are pretty effective versus stalkers. And Marauders too. Even though they don't have concussive shells. But they're still pretty strong. Yep, army just obliterates that Marine there. The Observer actually sees this army. His army is getting destroyed. Everything is getting focused down. But he does load up a couple of mini medevacs. But he jumps on the high ground. Will he be able? No, he will not be able to take that medevac. That medevac is going out safe and sound. Oh, he's safe. He's safe. Actually, he killed... No, he didn't, actually. Oh, actually got really excited there. But I thought he killed off a lot of workers. Let's actually check. Nope, this one. Workers killed. He did kill 9 workers there. But I don't think there was enough damage to even it up. Units, resources lost. Actually, it's not that bad for MMA. MMA lost 575 units. Actually, he's losing more because Feast is in his base with a couple of stalkers. We'll be able to blink to the low ground. Does kill off 2 stalkers there. That did even up the score a little bit. A little bit. So it was a decently effective battle. Build a couple of supply depots there since he has supply blocked. This factory flying up, probably going to be used for scouting. Once again, going for a heavy marine play. Does mix up a little bit with those marauders. He didn't do that in any of the previous matches. At least, yeah, he used a couple, but not really like mixing it up in really triple M style. Marine, marauder, medevacs. Actually, the stalkers, yeah, they're back in there again. But the stalkers will be able to blink to the... No, they won't be able to blink to the low ground. The Observer got killed off there. This Stalker does get out, but he lost an Observer. He lost a couple of Stalkers and probably didn't do the damage he needed to. No, Feast has lost way more units. Feast lost 1,975 resources. And MMA only lost 1,150, so... Feast, MMA is ahead here. So that's gonna be bad for Feast, since MMA is already very strong. And now he's also ahead, so... This is gonna be a pain. Army supplies 59 for MMA, 62 now. He's actually building more, and 64 Feast. So pretty even. Worker supplies 71 to for MMA, to versus Feast is 65. Set 2 there a little bit too fast. Meanwhile, Feast also building his third expansion up here. Probably MMA could expect this, but I don't know if Feast knows anything about this expansion up here. I don't know if he knows that. Actually, if he doesn't, that's actually pretty bad for him, since that base will be mining up a lot of stuff, even though it isn't gold or anything. There aren't any gold stuff here, but still pretty decent. Yes, he does indeed. Feast is teching up Psionic Storm, Psystorm, since MMA is building heavy marine, heavy marauder play. Just look at this huge death ball. A couple of storms in there, maybe two, maybe three, get kill of this entire army so easily. MMA is training up ghosts, very strong versus protoss if you utilize them right, but normally they're kinda wasted. I think they're actually really difficult to play, since they're like pretty strange units, but still, it's just pretty weird. This Zealot knowing his army is up here, Feast being happy with that intel, since should actually watch out, these probes are long distance mining, they could get taken out by those marines if they come in there. But nope, they don't. He's just getting up all his units. This is gonna be a huge battle. Huge battle. Does have a couple of immortals. I don't know if they're gonna be that great. I don't think they're gonna be that great, since you only block 2 damage from the marauders and no damage from the marines. He does do a lot of damage, but he gets taken out so quickly. This army, I don't know who's winning here. I think MMA is actually... Oh, Storm goes down, kills off a lot of units. MMA runs his units in there, but he is able to hold it up with another Storm, killing off a lot of units there. Storms are just so strong if you know to use them right. And MMA Feast is actually going for blood. He wants to kill, kills off a medevac. Might kill off a second. No, he doesn't, since reinforcements are indeed coming there. He does go for the fight. I don't know if Feast is enough to hold this on. The Zealots are gonna get taken out. Does throw down a Storm, but it was kind of misplaced. Should have threw it in the Death Ball, since his energy is out. So I don't know if he'll be able to hold on. There's just such a big army for us. Only these couple of Stalkers. Warping in more Zealots here. Trying to be meat shields, but I don't think... Yeah, he does GG. Might have held on in one epic last stand. But nope, he didn't. He died. He GG'd. Even though he had this base up, I don't know if actually MMA probably... Actually... No, not there. Yeah, he didn't knew that. He knew there was a pile on there, so could have expected it, but still. It's expected. Oh, apparently Feast did know of this base. Didn't know he had 3 bases up. Actually, he doesn't know of this base, but that's pretty obvious that you first go for a base here and then a base here, so. So still. He knew he had 3 bases. He only had 2 bases and a small army. Those medevacs healing up this huge bionic army. And it just killed off everything. Those immortals being completely useless. Since the special thing about immortals are the hardened shields, which makes it only possible to do 10 damage versus immortals, but marauders only do 12 damage with the 2 weapons upgrade, and marines only do 8, so only 2 damage blocked from the marauders. And there weren't even that much marauders. Like, that's... Let's check. Actually, 2 ghosts. Yeah, they were in the battle, but not very noticeable. Probably, actually, they took out a lot of shield from the immortal, but it's pretty hard to notice. 29 marauders. Actually, a lot of immortals. So. But, yeah. This was me, the Subin, commentating over this match between Slayers MMA and Millennium's Feast. Slayers MMA winning, so... Yay, go MMA. I'm actually rooting for MMA, since MMA is pretty cool. It plays pretty cool. Though the first match I ever did, didn't like that much, the Thor play, but I forgive you. I forgive you, MMA. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, then just press the like button under the video or on top here somewhere. And if you like my commentaries, then just press the subscribe button above this video and you'll get notified of my uploads. Thanks for watching. The Subin, out.